Lemo moj.
Thank you, Father, for your
Hvala
precious
ti,
work.
Oče, za tvojo dragoceno besedo.
I thank you that Holy Spirit, you reveal the truth to our hearts.
Hvala ti, Sveti Duh, da razodevaš resnico v naših srcih.
And I thank you, Lord, that your word is alive and powerful.
In hvala ti, Gospod, da je tvoja beseda živa in močna.
We receive from your heart tonight.
Mi danes sprejemamo od tebe,
Lord,
iz tvojega srca.
Help us to say just what's needed.
Pomagaj nam reči to, kar je potrebno.
And we give you all the glory.
In tebi dajemo vso slavo.
In Jesus' name. Amen.
V imenu Jezusa.
Okay, I'd like to talk to you about what kind of God we have.
Rada bi vam govorila o tem, kakšnega Boga mi imamo.
And the last time I talked about this, but I'm going to give you some more.
Zadnjič sem že govorila o tem, ampak vam bom še malo več o tem povedala.
So we last time we said that God is an abundant God.
In ko sem zadnjič govorila o tem, da je Bog izobilja.
He just gives too much.
On daje preobilo, preveč.
That's who he is.
Ker on tak je.
And so tonight I wanted to tell you about his home.
Vam danes želim govoriti o njegovem domu.
So let's talk about heaven.
Dajmo govoriti o nebesih.
You know that you can learn a lot about a person by where they live?
Veste, da lahko veliko izveste o človeku, ko vidite, kje živi.
If you want to learn more about someone, you go to their house.
Če se hočete naučiti, če hočete nekoga malo bolj spoznati, greš na obisk njegovo hišo.
So, if you came to my house,
če bi prišli v mojo hišo,
you would see that I really like bright colors.
Bi videl, da imam res rada svetle barve.
My kitchen is bright blue.
Moja kuhinja je svetlo modra.
My bathroom is bright coral color, like orangish pink sand.
Moja
color.
Kopalnica je svetlo oranžno rozasta.
If I went to your house, what would I see there?
Če bi šla jaz v tvojo hišo, kaj bi videla tam?
Maybe somebody likes fishing or hunting.
Mogoče ima nekdo rad ribolov ali
like gardening.
Ali pa vrtnari.
Maybe I just by looking at your house I could tell how busy your life is.
Ali pa bi videla, koliko zaposleno je tvoje življenje.
So one time there was this TV show about the lifestyles of rich and famous people.
Enkrat je bila ena televizijska oddaja o življenjskem slogu bogatih in slavnih ljudi.
And I'm telling you, they ought to take their cameras to heaven.
Ampak vam povem, oni bi morali nesti svoje kamere v nebesa.
They need to do a documentary on the Ancient of Days.
Morali bi narediti dokumentarni film o starodavnem, o Bogu.
Because God lives in great richness.
Zato ker Bog živi v ogromnem bogastvu.
In Revelation 21.
V Razodetju 21.
Verses 18 to 21.
Od 18 do 21.
It says the construction of its wall was of jasper and the city was pure gold like clear glass.
Pravi, da je gradivo mestnega obzidja iz jaspisa, mesto pa je iz suhega zlata. Podobnega čistemu kristalu.
The foundations of the wall of the city were adorned with all kinds of precious stones. The first foundation was jasper, the second sapphire, the third chalcedony, the fourth emerald.
Temelji mestnega obzidja so bili okrašeni z vsakovrstnim dragim kamenjem. Prvi temeljni kamen je bil jaspis, drugi safir, tretji halkedon, četrti smaragd.
The fifth, sardonyx, the sixth, sardius, the seventh, chrysolite, the eighth, beryl, the ninth, topaz, the tenth, chrysoprase, the 11th, jacinth, and the 12th, amethyst.
Peti sardonyx, šesti sardiš, sedmi chrysolit, osmi beril, deveti topaz, deseti chrysopras, enajsti hyacint, dvanajsti ametist.
The 12 gates were 12 pearls. Each individual gate was of one pearl. And the street of the city was pure gold, like transparent glass.
In 12 vrat je bilo 12 biserov. Posamezna vrata so bila iz enega samega bisera. Cesta skozi mesto pa je bila iz suhega zlata, kakor prosojen kristal.
So you see extravagance.
Torej vidite ekstravagantnost.
You see that God lives in abundance.
Vidite, da Bog živi v izobilju.
And think of, you know, his streets are not just paved with gold, they are gold.
Pomislite, njegove ceste niso samo prekrite z zlatom, ampak so iz zlata.
I mean, like what cement and asphalt is for us, gold is in heaven.
To, kar je za nas asfalt in cement, je zlato v nebesih.
And this is pure gold, like clear glass. We don't have pure gold like that here.
In to je čisto zlato, kakor prosojen kristal, tako čistega nimamo tukaj.
So, if it's a sin for someone to live in luxury while other people are starving on the planet, then God is the biggest sinner of all of them.
Tako da, če bi bil greh, da nekdo živi v luksuzu med tem, ko nekateri drugi stradajo, bi bil Bog največji grešnik.
But we know that it's not a sin to have an abundance.
Ampak vemo, da ni greh imeti izobilje.
Because God's abundance is for everyone.
Zato, ker Božje izobilje je za vsakogar.
So it's not just for a few people to be rich and everyone else be poor.
Ni samo za par ljudi, da bi bili bogati, vsi ostali pa ne bojo revni.
God wants us to live in abundance.
Bog želi, da živimo v izobilju.
That's his desire for us.
To je njegova želja za nas.
His abundance is not just for him to enjoy, it's for us.
Njegova izobilje ni samo da ga on uživa, ampak je za nas.
What would you think of a parent that kept all of their money to themselves and never helped their children?
Kaj bi si mislili o starših, ki držijo ves denar zase in nič ne dajo svojim otrokom?
You never see a parent like that, a good parent.
Ne vidite nikoli dobrega starša takega.
So God is, he lives in abundance in heaven.
In Bog živi v izobilju v nebesih.
And he wants us to have abundance.
In želi, da tudi mi imamo izobilje.
And everywhere you see God dwelling on the earth, it is rich.
In kjerkoli vidimo, da Bog prebiva na zemlji, je bogato.
The Garden of Eden was beautiful.
Edenski vrt je bil čudovit.
When they made the tabernacle in the wilderness.
Ko so naredili svetišče v puščavi.
It was overlaid with gold.
Je bilo prekrito z zlatom.
And it cost thousands of dollars to build it, maybe millions to build
it. In je stalo milijone v današnjem denarju, da so to sestavili.
They estimate maybe it cost close to several million dollars to build that tabernacle now.
Ocenili so, da bi zdaj to stalo več milijonov evrov, če bi danes to zgradili.
And this was a portable meeting tent.
In to je bil prenos, to je bilo prenosno svetišče.
If we spent $1 million on a church building,
če bi mi porabili 1 milijon evrov za cerkveno zgradbo,
people wouldn't stop talking about it for years.
Ljudje leta ne bi nehali govoriti o tem.
But when the temple was being built in the Old Testament.
In potem, ko je bil v stari zavezi tempel grajen.
This was extremely extravagant.
To je bilo izjemno ekstravagantno.
And King David, before he died, he gave a large offering towards the temple.
In kralj David je preden je umrl, dal veliko daritev za ta tempel.
He said in 1 Chronicles 22:5.
In pravi v prvi kroniški 22.
Now David said, Solomon my son is young and inexperienced, and the house to be built for the Lord must be exceedingly magnificent, famous and glorious throughout all countries. I will now make preparation for it. So David made abundant preparations before his death.
David je rekel, moj sin Salomon je mlad in neizkušen, hiša pa, ki naj bo sezidana Gospodu, mora biti nadvse veličastna, slavna in poveličevana po vseh deželah. Zato bom naredil zanjo priprave. David je torej pred svojo smrtjo pripravil veliko reči.
In verse 14.
In 14. vrstica.
It says, indeed I have taken much trouble to prepare for the house of the Lord 100,000 talents of gold and 1,000,000 talents of silver and bronze and iron beyond measure, for it is so abundant. I have prepared timber and stone also, and you may add to them.
Glej, z velikimi napori sem pripravil za gospodovo hišo 100 000 talentov zlata in 1 000 000 talentov srebra, tudi toliko brona in železa, da ga ni mogoče stehtati, ker ga je obilo. Tudi les in kamenje sem pripravil, k temu pa še ti dodaj.
Sometimes when we read this, we don't realize how much money this is.
Časa, ko to beremo, si ne predstavljamo, koliko velik denarja je to bilo.
So I looked it up on Google.
In sem pogledala na Googlu.
And one talent is about 50 kilograms of gold.
In en talent je okoli 50 kilogramov zlata.
And at today's price in euros, that's about 1.8 million euro for one talent.
In danes bi to bilo vredno 1,8 milijona evrov.
And so,
en sam talent.
And David gave 100,000 talents of gold.
In David je dal 100 000 talentov zlata.
We're talking about 183 trillion euros.
Govorimo o 183 tisoč milijardah evrov.
And it didn't stop there. He gave 1 million talents of silver.
In potem je dal še 1 000 000 talentov srebra.
And that's worth a lot too.
In tudi to je veliko vredno.
And then he just said bronze and iron beyond measure.
In potem je rekel brona in železa preko mere.
Because it is abundant.
Ker je tako izobilno.
And when he says abundant, he means abundant.
In ko pravi izobilno, to tako tudi misel.
And this was God's meeting place.
In to je bilo Božje svetišče, tam, kjer je Bog se srečeval z ljudmi.
Where the people would come and experience the presence of God.
Ljudje so prišli tja in izkusili Božjo prisotnost.
And we're talking trillions of dollars just in this offering from David.
In govorimo o tisočih milijardah dolarjev samo iz te daritve Davida.
And you know, when someone gives such a big offering like that, it really doesn't matter how much they have.
In ko nekdo da tako veliko daritev, sploh ni pomembno, koliko velik ima.
I mean, if someone gives trillions into the work of God,
če nekdo da trilijone v Božje delo,
what difference does it make how extravagant their house is?
Koliko pomembno je, kakšno je njegova, kako ekstravagantna je njegova hiša.
And what an amazing vehicle they drive.
In kakšen super avto vozi.
Right?
Je tako.
I mean, who can criticize someone that gives that much to the kingdom of God?
Kdo lahko kritizira nekoga, ki da tok veliko v Božje kraljestvo?
So I found this scripture one day in Ezekiel 16.
In našla sem tale odlomek enkrat v Ezekielu 16.
And this is the Lord talking about how he blessed his people Israel.
Tukaj Gospod govori o tem, kako je blagoslovil svoje ljudstvo Izrael.
In Ezekiel 16 verses 10 through 14.
Ezekiel 16 10 do 14.
The Lord is speaking here.
Bog tukaj govori.
I clothed you in embroidered cloth and gave you sandals of badger skin. I clothed you with fine linen and covered you with silk. Do you want to go verse by verse?
Oblekel sem te v pisano vezanino, ti obul usnjene sandale, te opasal s tankim platnom in ogrnil se svilo.
I adorned you with ornaments, put bracelets on your wrists and a chain on your neck.
Okrasil sem te z nakitom, zapestnici sem ti dal na roke in ogrlico okoli vratu.
And I put a jewel in your nose, earrings in your ears, and a beautiful crown on your head.
Dal sem ti obroček v nos, uhane v ušesa in lepo krono na glavo.
Thus you were adorned with gold and silver, and your clothing was of fine linen, silk, and embroidered cloth. You ate pastry of fine flour, honey, and oil. You were exceedingly beautiful and succeeded to royalty.
Okrašena si bila zlatom in srebrom, tvoja obleka je bila iz tankega platna, iz svile in pisane vezenine.
Your fame went out among the nations because of your beauty, for it was perfect through my splendor which I had bestowed upon you, says the Lord God.
Tvoje ime je prodrlo med narode zaradi tvoje lepote, saj je bila popolna za voljo sijaja, ki sem ti ga nadel, govori Gospod Bog.
So we see that to be dressed in nice clothes, wear jewelry, is something that God likes.
Torej vidimo, da to, da si oblečen v lepo obleko in imaš nakit, je nekaj, kar je Bogu všeč.
When I saw this verse, I realized it's a good thing to wear jewelry, so that's why I wear jewelry.
Ko sem prebrala to, sem ugotovila, da je v redu imeti nakit in zato ga imam na sebi.
God would love for his people to be dressed nice.
Bogu je všeč, da so njegovi ljudje lepo oblečeni.
To wear fine clothes.
Da imajo dobre oblačila.
Good shoes.
Dobre čevlje.
Right? He wants you not to buy the cheap stuff that wear out in 2 months.
Noče, da si kupaš pocen stvari, ki se izrabijo v 2 mesecih.
He wants you to be beautiful.
Hoče, da izgledate lepo.
Because he gets glory from that.
Ker je on proslavljen čez to.
He wants you to be covered in blessings.
Želi, da si pokrit z blagoslovi.
We could go on, but let's just go on. So we don't need to be envious of what other people have.
Tako da nam ni treba zavidati temu, kar imajo drugi ljudje.
Do you remember how the 10th commandment says do not covet?
Veste, kaj pravi 10. zapoved, ne poželi?
So why?
Zakaj?
Because we can have everything that God has.
Zato ker mi lahko imamo vse, kar ima Bog.
We don't have to envy someone's car.
Ni nam treba biti zavistni zaradi avta nekoga drugega.
We could say, Lord, I really would like to have a nice looking car like that.
In lahko rečemo, Gospod, jaz bi tudi rad imel tak lep avto, kakor je tale.
And he can do it.
In on to lahko priskrbi.
He can bless you with that.
On te lahko blagoslovi s tem.
We don't have to be envious of other people's things.
Ni nam treba biti zavistni za stvari drugih ljudi.
God loves to bless you.
Bogu je zelo všeč, da te blagoslovi.
It makes him happy.
Razveseli se s tem.
Just like with your children.
Tako kakor tvoji otroci.
It makes you happy when they're dressed beautifully.
Vesel si, ko so lepo oblečeni.
Their hair is beautiful.
Ko so njihovi lasje urejeni.
They're wearing new shoes.
Ko imajo nove čevlje.
Right?
Je tako.
Okay. So we can put our trust in the Lord to bless us.
In mi lahko svoje zaupanje stavimo v Gospoda, da nas blagoslovi.
And when your trust is in the Lord, you never put pressure on people.
In ko je tvoje zaupanje v Gospoda, nikoli ne boš pritiskal na ljudi.
We never have to say, you need to give this to me or I won't have it.
Nikoli ne bom rekel, moraš mi tole dati, drugače ne bom imel tega.
No, the Lord can give it to us.
Ne, Gospod nam lahko to da.
We need to put our trust in him.
Mi rabimo dati svoje zaupanje v njega.
He has more than enough for us.
On ima več kot dovolj za nas.
And he likes for us to ask him.
In mu je všeč, da ga prosimo.
He doesn't want us to look for other places to get our needs met.
Noče, on ne rabi iskati nekje drugje za to, da poskrbi za naše potrebe.
So he wants us to be rich so that we can be self-sufficient.
On želi, da smo bogati za to, da imamo več kot dovolj.
So that we don't have to beg from other people.
Da nam ni treba prosjačiti od drugih ljudi.
Right? And you know, the poor are beggars.
Reveži prosjačijo.
Maybe they're not standing on the street with a bucket.
Mogoče ne stojijo na ulici z košarco.
But maybe they're begging from people.
Ampak mogoče prosjačijo pri ljudeh.
Do you have something I could eat?
A imaš kaj za pojest?
And they pull on people's emotions.
In emocionalno vlečejo od ljudi.
But we can trust the Lord and he will give us abundance.
Mi pa lahko zaupamo od Boga in on nam bo dal izobilje.
Now, there's a scripture in Mark 4, verse 25.
Je odlomek v Markovem evangeliju 4.
And this scripture was difficult for me to understand for a long time.
In ta odlomek sem težko razumela dolg časa.
And one day I saw it.
Enkrat pa sem zagledala.
So Jesus said, for whoever has, to him more will be given. But whoever does not have, even what he has will be taken away from him.
Jezus je rekel v Marku 4:25, kdor namreč ima, se mu bo dalo, in kdor nima, se mu bo vzelo tudi to, kar ima.
One day I saw it.
Enkrat sem spregledala.
You have two kinds of people.
imamo dve vrste ljudi.
You have consumers.
Imamo porabnike.
And you have producers.
In imamo te, ki proizvajajo.
So consumers eat everything that comes their way.
Porabniki pojejo vse, kar pride na njihovo pot.
Producers create things.
Te, ki proizvajajo, ki ustvarjajo, pa kreirajo stvari.
If you put money into the hands of a rich person,
če daš denar v roke bogatega človeka,
they will multiply that.
Bojo to pomnožili.
They will take 10 euro and make it 100.
Bojo iz 10 evrov naredili 100.
Or 1000.
Ali 1000.
And if you put that same $10 in the hand of a poor person,
če pa daš teh istih 10 dolarjev, 10 evrov v roke revežu,
they will go buy a pizza.
Bojo šli po pico.
And it's gone.
In je šlo.
Right?
Je tako.
So we have two kinds of people.
Imamo dve vrste ljudi.
And which one do you think that God would like us to be?
In kateri od teh mislite, da Bog želi, da smo?
Producers.
Te, ki ustvarjajo.
Or you could say investors.
Ali lahko bi rekel, te, ki investirajo.
And we can take our finances and invest it into the kingdom of God and it will multiply.
Mi lahko vzamemo svoje finance in jih vložimo v Božje kraljestvo in se bo pomnožilo.
Now, there's basically two ways to get what you want.
V bistvu sta dva načina, kako dobiti to, kar hočeš.
You can get the things you want the world's way or God's way.
Eden je posveten način, eden je pa Božji način.
The world's way would be to beg.
Način tega sveta bi bil prosjačiti.
To steal.
Ali krst.
To borrow.
Ali si sposojati.
To go into debt.
Ali iti v dolgove.
Or even to work hard.
Ali pa celo, da trdo delaš.
But God's way is that you can give to be your way into being rich.
Božji način je pa, da daješ na svoji poti, ko postaješ bogatejši.
So it's not what you have, but how you got it.
Ne gre za to, kaj imaš, ampak kako si to dobil.
So if you have a really nice car,
torej, če imaš res lep avto,
and you worked hard for it,
in si trdo delal za njega,
what's wrong with that?
Aj, kaj narobe s tem?
What if God gave you a car?
Kaj pa, če ti je Bog dal avto?
What could be wrong with that?
Kaj bi bilo narobe s tem?
Should you be ashamed to drive that nice car?
A bi se moral sramovati, da voziš ta lep avto?
No.
Ne.
I'm trying to stir your faith up here.
Poskušam razuneti vašo vero.
But what if you took the offering from the church and went out and bought a car?
Kaj pa, če bi vzel daritev cerkve in šel kupati si avto?
Right? That would be wrong.
To bi bilo narobe.
So it's not what you have, but how you got it.
Ne gre za to, kaj imaš, ampak kako si to dobil.
I know a minister that had this really big house with tennis courts and swimming pool.
Poznam enega božjega služabnika, ki je imel res veliko hišo s tenis igriščem in bazenom.
And the Lord, he said the Lord gave him this house.
In je rekel, Gospod mi je dal to hišo.
He paid less for that than many people pay for their apartment.
On je plačal za to manj, kakor mnogi plačajo za svoje stanovanje.
And that's how the Lord likes to bless us.
In tako, na tak način nas Bog rad blagoslavlja.
Okay, in 1 Timothy 6:10.
1. Timotejev 6:10.
Those who desire to be rich fall into temptation and a snare into many foolish and harmful lusts which drown men in destruction and perdition. For the love of money is a root of all kinds of evil, for which some have strayed from the faith in their greediness and pierced themselves through with many sorrows.
Tisti, ki želijo biti bogati, padejo v skušnjavo in zanko v mnoge neumne in nevarna poželenja, ki vlečejo ljudi v uničenje in pogubo. Korenine vsega zla je namreč pohlep po denarju, potem so nekateri hlepeli in tako zablodili proč od vere, s tem pa sami sebi zadali veliko bolečin.
So if you desire to be rich just for the ease and the luxury that it gives you,
če ti želiš biti bogat samo zaradi lahkotnosti in luksuza, ki ti jo to prinaša,
The Bible says that that desire will cause you much sorrow.
Sveto pismo pravi, da ti bo ta želja prinesla veliko bolečin.
But if your desire is to build up and expand the kingdom of God,
če pa je tvoja želja, da gradiš in širaš Božje kraljestvo,
then you will not have sorrow with it.
Ne boš imel bolečine s tem.
You will be blessed.
Boš blagoslovljen.
In verse 17 through 19.
Od 17. do 19. vrstice.
It says, command those who are rich in this present age to get rid of their riches. I'm joking.
Ja, ne piše, bogatašem tega sveta naročaj, naj se znebijo svojega bogatstva.
No, it doesn't say that,
ne,
right?
Ne pravi tega.
It says not to be haughty or proud.
Pravi, naroča jim, naj se ne prevzamejo, naj ne bodo ponosni.
Nor to trust in uncertain riches.
Naj ne stavijo svojega upanja v nezanesljivost bogatstva.
But in the living God who gives us richly all things to enjoy.
Ampak na živega Boga, ki nam obilno daje vsega v uživanje.
So the Lord wants us to put our trust in Him to give the things that we need.
Gospod želi, da postavimo svoje zaupanje v njega za stvari, ki jih potrebujemo.
And then he continues speaking to the rich here.
Potem pa še naprej govori tukaj bogatim.
Let them do good, that they be rich in good works, ready to give, willing to share, storing up for themselves a good foundation for the time to come, that they may lay hold on eternal life.
Dobrodelni naj bojo in naj se bogatijo z dobrimi deli, naj bodo radodarni, naj z drugimi delijo to, kar imajo. Tako si bodo nabrali zaklad, ki bo dober temelj za prihodnost in tako bodo dosegli resnično življenje.
So this is what really makes you rich.
To je tisto, kar te zares naredi bogatega.
Not having money,
ne, da imaš denar,
but when you're rich in good works,
ampak ko si bogat v dobrih delih,
you're a giver,
ko si ta človek, ki daje.
Amen. And people are afraid of this message because they are afraid of becoming greedy.
Ljudje se bojijo tega sporočila, ker se bojijo postati pohlepni.
But you realize the opposite happens.
Ampak pomislite, če se nasprotno od tega zgodi.
When you see how good a God we have, it makes you want to let go of your riches.
Ko vidiš, kako dober je naš Bog, si želiš dati svoje bogatstvo.
To be generous everywhere.
Biti radodaren vse povsod.
Because God has plenty.
Ker Bog ima obilje.
No problem. If I give to you, it's just going to come back to me.
Ni problem, če dam tebi, mi bo prišlo nazaj.
And God has a lot of money.
Bog ima veliko denarja.
Some people think that God, if he had 4 euro in his hand,
eni ljudje mislijo, da če bi Bog imel 4 evre v svoji roki,
and you took one of the euro,
in bi en evro vzel v stran,
that he would only have 3 left.
Da bi njemu ostalo samo še 3 evre.
But if you take one, he still has 4 and more is on the way.
Ampak če ti vzameš enega, on ima še vedno 4 in še veliko več jih je na poti.
You know what happened to me when I first heard this message?
Veste, kaj se mi je zgodilo, ko sem prvič slišala to sporočilo?
It's really interesting the effect that it had on me.
Zelo zanimiv učinek je to imel name.
I had better posture.
Imela sem, bolje sem se držala.
I used to walk around like this.
Običajno sem hodila naokoli takole.
And then I heard that God wants to bless me.
In potem sem slišala, da me Bog hoče blagosloviti.
Like, really?
Sem rekla, o, res.
And another effect is I started wearing the clothes that were the nicer clothes in my closet.
In druga posledica je bila, da sem začela nositi obleke, ki so bile med lepšimi v moji omari.
I started increasing my offerings.
Začela sem povečevati svoje daritve.
I started giving not just offerings, but everywhere.
Začela sem dajati ne samo daritve v cerkvi, ampak vse povsod.
And this is what God wants.
In to Bog hoče.
For us to be liberal givers.
Za nas, da smo širokosrčni darovalci.
Okay, let's talk about hard work now.
Zdaj pa govorimo o trdem delu.
Now, this is one way to get rich.
In to je en način, da obogatiš.
But it's not the best way.
Ampak ni najboljši način.
We all know people that have worked really hard.
Mi vsi poznamo ljudi, ki so zares trdo delali.
They hardly get sleep.
Komaj spijo.
their hands are all you know, you could see the work on their hands.
Njihove roke so zgarane od dela.
They just don't look healthy.
Ne izgledajo zdravi.
So it's not just hard work.
Tako da ne gre samo za trdo delo.
Ecclesiastes 10:10.
Pridigar 10:10.
It says if the axe is dull and one does not sharpen the edge, then he must use more strength. But wisdom brings success.
Če je sekira topa in kdo ne nabrušeno vihti, mora napenjati moči, bolje je uporabljati modrost, modrost prinese uspeh.
So if you're going to chop down a tree,
če hočeš posekati drevo,
and your axe head is dull,
in imaš topo sekiro,
you're going to be using a lot of effort.
Boš veliko moči potreboval in truda.
But wisdom would say, maybe I should sharpen my axe.
Ampak modrost bi rekla, mogoče moram nabrusati svojo sekiro.
And you sit down and start sharpening.
In se usedeš in začneš brusati.
And other people are out there working with their dull axes.
Drugi pa tam delajo s svojimi topimi sekirami.
And it looks like you're behind.
Izgleda, kakor da ti zaostajaš.
But then, when your axe is sharp, you give it 3 big whacks and it's down.
Ampak potem, ko je tvoja sekira ostra, trikrat udaraš in je drevo podrto.
So God is trying to say it's not just hard work.
Tako da Bog hoče nam reči, da ne gre samo za trdo delo.
But it's wisdom.
Ampak za modrost.
We need wisdom.
Potrebujemo modrost.
And there's only one place to get wisdom.
In samo na enem mestu dobimo modrost.
Anybody know?
A kdo od vas ve?
From God.
Od Boga.
God is wisdom.
Bog je modrost.
Right?
Je tako.
And so when we come to him and we get wisdom, we can work smarter.
Ko pridemo k njemu in dobimo modrost, lahko delamo pametneje.
So years ago I was working for a dentist.
Pred leti sem delala za zobozdravnika.
And it was a good job.
In je bilo dobro delo.
I mean, it was good pay.
Dobro plačano.
But I was working really hard.
Ampak zares sem trdo delala.
And I was there for 6 years.
Tam sem bila 6 let.
But the last 6 months of those 6 years, I was working the job like 2 people's work.
Zadnjih 6 mesecev v tej službi pa sem delala kakor da za dva.
I was running around like a chicken with its head cut off.
Tekala sem naokol kakor piščanc z odrezano glavo.
I run and sterilize the instruments.
Hitela sem sterilizirati instrumente.
I'd seat the patients in the rooms.
Posaditi paciente v sobo.
Set up everything for the procedure.
Postaviti vse za operacijo.
Write in their files.
Pisala v kartoteke.
And clean up the room afterwards.
Potem počistila sobo.
Take x-rays.
Rentgen slikala.
And take impressions.
In odtise zob delala.
And it was hard work.
In to je bilo trdo delo.
When summertime came,
ko je prišlo poletje,
the dentist I was working for took a week off.
Si je ta zobozdravnik, za katerega sem delala, vzel en teden dopusta.
So I had to take a week off.
In sem si morala tudi jaz vzeti en
teden
dopusta.
Because the office was closed.
Ker je bila ordinacija zaprta.
And I just purposed to pray through.
In sem se odločila, da prodrem v molitvi.
I needed to seek God about this job.
Morala sem iskati Boga glede te situacije s službo.
So I sat on the couch and I buried my head in my hands.
In sem sedela na kavču in zakopala svojo glavo v roke.
And I prayed in tongues for an hour.
In eno uro molila v jezikih.
And as I was praying, I said, God, help me. I don't know what to do.
In ko sem molila, sem rekla, Bog, pomagaj mi, ne vem, kaj ne naredim.
I'm using all this energy and effort.
So to energijo in trud vlagam.
And I'm not not called to be a dentist.
Pa nisem poklicana za zobozdravnico.
It's really just a job to make money.
To je samo ena služba, kjer lahko zaslužim.
And as I kept on praying, the Lord showed me what I really was called to be.
In ko sem molila naprej, mi je Gospod pokazal, kaj sem zares poklicana, da sem.
And I realized that music was more my gifting.
In sem odkrila, da je glasba res tisti moj pomembnejši dar.
And at that time, I was an advanced piano player.
In takrat nisem bila izvrstna igralka na klavirju.
And I also had a few piano students.
Imela sem nekaj, ko sem jih inštruirala klavir.
So, while I was praying, I saw a path towards being the dentist.
Ko sem molila, sem videla pot v to, da postanem zobozdravnica.
And I realized that's not for me.
In sem ugotovila, da to ni zame.
And I realized music is the path I'm supposed to head towards.
In sem videla, da je glasba ta pot, po kateri bi morala iti naprej.
So when I prayed, I made the decision to pursue music.
Tako da, ko sem molila, sem se odločila, da sledim to pot, glasba.
I'm going to take some more lessons and I'm going to take more students.
Učila se bom nove lekcije in tudi dodatne študente bom vzela za inštrukcije.
After that week was over, I went back to work.
Ko je ta teden minil, sem šla nazaj na delo.
And I was immediately fired.
In sem bila takoj odpuščena.
Or I quit. I can't. It was mutual.
sem dala odpoved ali pa oboje hkrati.
And the Lord opened up a position at a music academy for me.
In Gospod mi je odprl položaj v glasbeni akademiji.
And I worked this music academy for 10 years.
In sem delala tam 10 let.
And the Lord taught me how to teach.
In Gospod me je naučil, kako učiti.
So it's not hard working, but it's wisdom.
Ne gre za trdo delo, ampak za modrost.
You know, it's not before you take off running, you need to make sure you're heading in the right direction.
Preden začneš teč, se moraš prepričati, da greš v pravo smer.
Okay. Okay, so with the Lord, he is so abundant toward us.
Gospod je tako izobilen do nas.
And let me wrap up with just this part right here.
S tem bi rada zaključila.
With God there is no such thing as a fixed income.
Pri Bogu ni nekega fiksnega prihodka.
People think that the salary they make is the only money that can ever come to them.
Ljudje mislijo, da plača, ki
by your need through many sources.
V Božjem kraljestvu Bog lahko preskrbi tvoje potrebe skozi mnoge vire.
People have sent me money in the mail.
Ljudje so mi poslali denar po pošti.
People have knocked on the door and handed me money.
Ljudje so potrkali na moja vrata in mi izročili denar.
People have bought me clothing.
Ljudje so mi kupili obleko.
People have bought me food.
Kupili so mi hrano.
God can meet your needs in lots of ways.
Bog lahko poskrbi za tvoje potrebe na mnoge načine.
Amen.
Je tako.
And so there's no such thing as a fixed income.
Ne obstaja samo fiksen prihodek.
Don't limit yourself to what your job pays you.
Ne omejuj se samo s tem zneskom, kaj ti tvoja služba plačuje.
Dan said this to me one day.
Dan mi je tole enkrat rekel.
He said, our income will never go down.
Rekel je, najin prihodek ne bo nikoli šel navzdol.
Because we continue to be givers.
Zato, ker sva vedno dajalca.
And the more you're sowing, the more you're reaping.
In več seješ, več bo žel.
Amen.
Je tako.
So, but let me show you how you can pray and get the money that you need.
Naj vam pokažem, kako lahko moleš in dobiš denar, ki ga potrebuješ.
The Lord spoke to Kenneth Hagin.
Bog je govoril Kennethu Haginu.
And he said to him, don't pray for money like you've been doing.
In mu je rekel, ne mol za denar tako, kakor si do zdaj.
Because Brother Hagin was saying, Lord, please, I need $200. Can you please send me $200?
Brat Hagin je rekel, Gospod, prosim, rabam $200, a jih prosim, pošleš men.
And the Lord spoke to him and said, don't pray like that anymore.
In Gospod mu je govoril in rekel, ne več tako molit.
He said, money is not in heaven.
Rekel je, denarja ni v nebesih.
And I can't send it down, that'd be like counterfeiting.
Jaz ti ga ne moram poslati dol, ker bi bilo to ponarejeno.
Money is in this realm here.
Denar je v tem področju na zemlji.
And the way the Lord meets your needs is through the hands of other people.
In kako Bog poskrbi za tvoje potrebe je skozi roke drugih ljudi.
And so this is how the Lord taught him to pray, to believe God for money.
Takole ga je Bog naučil, da verjame za denar in moli.
He said first, determine how much you need.
Najprej določi, koliko potrebuješ.
And claim what you need by faith.
In sprejmi to, kar potrebuješ po veri.
Then he said, command the devil to let go of that money.
Potem zapovej hudiču, da spusti ta denar.
And then pray that the angels will go and bring it in.
In potem moli, da bojo angeli šli in ga prinesli do tebe.
So Dan and I heard about this one day.
Z Danom sva enkrat slišala za to.
And it was December, we needed money.
In je bil december in sva potrebovala denar.
Our car insurance was due.
Bil je rok za plačilo zavarovanja za avto.
Christmas presents we needed to buy.
Morala sva kupiti darila za Božič.
And then all of the other expenses we had.
In potem so bile še vse drugi stroški.
So we wrote down everything we needed for that month.
Zapisala, kaj vse potrebujeva za ta mesec.
And then we took hands together.
In potem sva se držala za roke.
And we said, now in the name of Jesus, we claim this money.
In sva rekla, zdaj v imenu Jezusa sprejemava ta denar.
And devil, take your hands off of this money.
In hudič roke stran z tega denarja.
Angels go, bring this money into us.
Angeli pejte in prineste ta denar do naju.
And then we thanked God.
In potem sva se zahvalila Bogu.
And we went believing that the money was on the way.
In sva šla naprej v veri, da je denar na poti.
I'm telling you, money started coming in.
In povem vam, denar je začel prihajati.
It was amazing.
Bilo je osupljivo.
Someone gave Dan a job to do.
Nekdo je dal Danu delo.
And when Dan quoted him a price,
in ko mu je Dan dal ponudbo,
he said, I don't think that's enough.
Je rekel, mislim, da to ni dovolj.
Dan said, how about $400?
In je Dan rekel, kaj pa $400?
He said, that's not enough. And he went up to $700.
In je rekel, ne, to ni dovolj. Je povišil na 700.
And then he gave him another job to do.
In potem mu je dal še drugo delo.
Because his work was so done so well.
Zato, ker je prvo delo tako dobro opravil.
And people handed us money.
In ljudje so nama dali denar.
The last day of that month, someone handed us $20.
Zadnji del tega meseca nama je nekdo dal $20.
Which was exactly the amount that we had claimed.
In to je bilo točno ta znesek, vsega skupaj je bilo točno znesek, ki sva ga sprejela po veri.
And I remember Lester Sumrall one time had prayed for money that he needed.
Spomnim se, da je Lester Sumrall enkrat molil za denar, ki ga je potreboval.
And this envelope came in the mail for him.
In ta kuverta je prišla po pošti do njega.
It had rained on the envelope, so the address was washed away.
Dežvalje na to kuverto in je bila, naslov je bil izbrisan.
So he didn't know who it came from.
Tako da ni vedel, od kje prišlo.
And then when he opened it up, it was exactly the amount of money he needed.
In ko je odprl kuverto, je bil točno znesek, ki ga je potreboval.
I mean exactly.
Točno.
And he said to the Lord, but Lord, I don't even have 10 cents to get ice cream.
In je rekel, ampak Gospod, jaz nimam niti 10 centov za sladoled.
I mean like 10 cents extra than this.
Nimam niti 10 centov dodatno.
And the Lord said, you didn't ask me for ice cream.
In je rekel, Gospod, nisi me prosil za sladoled.
So when you were asking for it, make sure that you think about giving your tithe, so get 10% extra.
Tako da, ka prosaš, si izračunaj, da boš lahko dal tudi desetino, dodaj 10%.
And add just a little bit extra.
Dodaj še več.